Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophynet and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We're here still in Lothric Castle, right in front of another boss fork of something that looks like a giant spaghetti monster. But I guess we'll find out in a minute. I have switched back to my Uchi Katana just to have that raw damage available to me. And of course I still have the Ring of Sacrifice equipped for when I eventually, inevitably, die, so that I still have all my souls. But let's see what all of this is about now, shall we? Okay, Dragonslayer Armour. Whoa, 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 okay, I was distracted. Okay, okay. Holy shit. Shit, okay, never mind, didn't expect that one. Whoa, okay. What the hell is going on over there? Whoa! Ah, fuck. Okay. Okay. Okay, so the Ring of Sacrifice has been shattered, but I keep all my stuff. That was actually really well done. I was completely sidetracked by those flying spaghetti thingies. But now that I still have my 71,000 souls, I'm gonna head back to Firelink Shrine and spend those first. So see you guys there in a minute. Okay. So we'll put in two levels, I think. That should be doable. Yeah, looks like it's doable. Let's put one in dexterity and one in intelligence again, to eventually get that up to 40 and 30 respectively. I think I can upgrade the katana once more. So reinforce. Katana, there we go, we have 8 titanite chunks, we only need 6. That gives us a nice boost, and now we'll probably need a slab to upgrade it to plus 10. Interesting. It still only is a B scaling, so I wonder if I might find something else that I might be able to enchant with something. It also has nice dexterity scaling. Do I or don't I have something like that? Well, we have the scimitars, but that's a bit stupid now, isn't it? Nothing specifically seems to have good native scaling, so I might as well try out the rapier. I have a lot of shards left, so I'll put it at plus 7 and I'll try and infuse it with crystal, I think. So I get magic damage and intelligence scaling. There we go. Crystal rapier plus 6. Why does it drop one, actually? That's a bit weird. So adds magic damage. There we go. Crystal rapier. Can I reinforce that then or not? I can, but I need the chunks. Yeah, okay, it's a crystal rapier plus 6 right now. Kinda looked at that the wrong way. But hey, let's upgrade it once more. We'll see how it goes. Now we still have a lot of souls left. Might also equip something else here. Maybe go for sorceries. Didn't really see that many openings for him to let me attack in between his. That still gives me. Yeah, okay, so now I can switch between the rapier and the katana. So let's see if we can't learn something from Orbeck here. Nothing really of interest, actually.
Come again.
So let's see if Carl, I think her name was, I can buy something, because she had the more expensive sorceries. Dark Edge. Might eventually want to use that, so let's try that. Thank you. So there we go. All set. I'm quickly going to check out the moveset. Just stabs. And if I two-hand it, and if I special attack, okay, and the special attack air one, ooh, dodge, interesting, okay. So let's go back to Lothric Castle and try to defeat the Dragonslayer armor. So I'm gonna start at Lothric Castle itself, because I have... You know what? I'm even going to start at the Dancer of the Boreal Valley. Because we have a shortcut here right now. So if I go up the ladder, we can get to the elevator pretty quickly. And then we end up at the Dragonslayer armor immediately. So I'm going to try and ignore these guys. I think I'm fast enough to... Bye. So yeah, they're way too slow to attack me in this stage. So I must say, this boss battle has a really cool introduction. Because you're really distracted by the giant flaming moth rising from, well, that thing. So let's put the elevator back down. And head back in, so wish me luck! Oh wow, it still reached me! Katana seems to have a bigger range for this. God damn it, this is dumb! Oh wow! Yeah! Okay, never mind. Okay. Oh shit! It is attacking me now. Okay, fuck off! Wow, okay, never mind. One hit kill. Wow. Come on, come on, come on. I got greedy. Okay. He usually doesn't start with that. Snap. Last Estus. God damn it. Shouldn't have been able to hit me there. Down he goes! Down he goes! I'm gonna drink before those guys attack me again. Okay! Okay! Dragonslayer armor down. Whew. And down. Where are they going? Are they dying? Whoa, they are dying. Holy crap. Okay then, I didn't think this has anything. Nope. So, pretty tough fight. I am a bit squishy, of course, because I don't have really fancy armor on. Because I'm going for the fashion soles more than the beefy armor. So there were quite a few attacks that could one-shot me, but his lightning strike was actually... Well, it could one-hit you, but it's also the best opportunity to get behind him and get a few hits in. Otherwise, just learn his attacks and roll through them. And you should be fine eventually. Okay, okay. We did it. So let's light the bonfire. I'm gonna head back to Firelink Shrine. Because I haven't checked the Shrine Handmaiden's inventory in a while. So let's go check that out. Okay, so we're gonna do that first. So let's check up with her. Purchase items. She usually sells armor from bosses, so I am wondering if there's anything of interest. Why is Aegon's gear in here? Huh. A Karim knight will dedicate an entire career to attending a single maiden, just as Morn once served one goddess alone. Interesting, but does that mean he's dead? Ooh, the dancer's gear. That is actually really interesting. I'm gonna buy that. Smaug's armor is also very interesting. What else do we have here? The executioner gear. Nothing else, apparently. The Xantus overcoat. Nothing of interest except for the dancer's gear. Crown worn by the dancer of the Boreal Valley. The mirage-like aura veil is said to be an article of the old gods, permitted only for direct descendants of the old royal family. So that gives you that veil. Let's buy all of that. Oh, wait a second, everything says something else. The black eyes of the pontiff eventually transformed the dancer into a beastly creature, her armor fusing with her own hide. Okay, that's what everything else says as well.
Ashen one.
Let's see what I can equip of that. So, dancer's armor, it's a bit beefier, but a bit lighter as well. Interesting. It's a lot lighter. But I do lose a lot of fire defense. Look at that. That's actually kind of creepy. And if I equip the crown, what then? Oh, I get that. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Well, hell yeah. Maybe I should go for her gauntlets then as well. They're a bit heavier, but they protect more as well. So let's go with those. Oh, God, that looks eerie. That looks really eerie. And so the cape is part of the helmet and not the armor. Which is weird, so I can equip something else as armor. Okay, and have it not upgrade. Oh, there we go. This is weird. Well, I think this is actually cooler. I could also wear the Silver Knight armor. How does that look, actually?
Woo!
That looks really nice, but then I'm slow rolling, so I'm not gonna do that. Although I could remove the rapier, and I'm just below everything there. So that actually looks really cool. Might roll with this for a while. Double capes, like it should. And we still roll pretty fast. That's really cool. Okay, so we're gonna level up once, I
welcome
presume.
Speak. Very well then taken.
I'm gonna put one more point into dexterity and leave it at 35 for a bit. And then we'll put some in vitality and intelligence later on when we get a few bit more souls. Although 30,000. Well, you know what? I'm first gonna check out Ludlit's inventory. He, who knows what he can make from the soul that we found. I should actually read that first. Soul of Dragonslayer Armor. The Dragonslayer Armor, controlled by the Pilgrim Butterfly, lost its master long ago, but still remembers their sporting hunts. So the armor was controlled by that fire butterfly. Interesting. The Pilgrim Butterfly. Lost its master long ago, but still remembers its their sporting hunts. Lost its master. Is that referring to Ornstein then? Because he was a Dragonslayer as well?
Aha, so.
Okay, what new things do we have here? Probably the weapon, yeah. Dragonslayer Great Axe, Melted Iron Great Axe that once formed part of the Dragonslayer Armour, thickly imbued with the power of lightning. Use skill to draw upon the techniques used to slay the Arch Dragons. Falling Bolt, hold axe high in the air to gather fierce lightning and smash ground to whip the bolts to the ground. Okay, and it has native lightning effects, but it needs a hell of a lot of strength. What else do we have here? Old King's Great Hammer, did I check? Old Demon King. Never mind. Ooh, the shield, of course. Look at that thing. Melted Iron Shield that once formed part of the Dragonslayer armor. The shield offers high protection to lightning, which the Dragonslayer commanded as his own, and its skill has faint echoes of the Dragonslayer's own fighting style. Shield Bash. Yeah, that's pretty standard, I presume. Gonna leave it at that. Do not be away over long. Wonder if anybody else has something to say, something new to say.
Ashen One, may I pose thee a question?
Yes, you can.
Has the little Lord Ludlath spoken to thee of any curious matters? I sense that he possesseth some knowledge of a thing once most precious or most terrible, now lost to the Firekeepers. Pray tell. Is it a matter of which I should be apprised?
I don't really know what you're talking about. Maybe you're talking about soul transposition? I don't know how that could help you. So the only thing we found that could help the Firekeepers was the soul that I gave her. And I don't think... Lovett asked me anything. Maybe I should check back at the tower behind Firelink Shrine, Firelink Tower, if there's anything that has changed. Maybe something else has been hidden there now. So let's take a quick look. Well, quick is overstating it, but a quick jog up the tower should maybe illuminate us a bit more. Ugh. I haven't been in here for quite some time, so I'm wondering if anything has changed. The elevator is down. So. What the? What was that? What was that noise? What was that noise? It was a loud metallic clank. I don't know if you guys heard that, but that was weird. So this body is still here. Don't want to fall off now. Doesn't seem to be anything over here. Maybe I should walk around it again? It doesn't seem to be anything here. Nope, still nothing. Same as before. So let's return down then. Just had a hunch something would happen, but that was weird. Oh! What?
Sorry, friend. Be more careful. By the gods, curiosity is gonna kill you, kittens. Some places are better left alone, you know. Oh, sorry. Am I a tad too late?
Oh, you asshole.
Have no fear. There's beauty in death. Besides, you're amongst your own. Plenty of company, right?
So, Dark Souls fan might know who this guy is. This is Patches the Hyena. The guy that, in every Dark Souls game, fucks you over.
Oh, no matter. I'll look after things. By stripping every last trinket off your corpse, you're gonna make some lucky customer very happy.
And he always kind of tricks you, but he's one of the best merchants in the game. So that's a bit double now, isn't it? Well, we have been going down here a few times, so there we go. So let's just do that again now, shall we? Jump over here, then jump over there. Then jump down, and we're already where we need to be. Because Patches isn't going to defeat us now, is he? So let's get back up and confront the bugger with what he has done. I kind of feel bad killing these now. I don't think there's actually a faster way up there, so... Can I open this then again? Where the hell did he go? Or did he go up now? Hopefully he doesn't do that again, because... That would be rather annoying. Nope, nope, nope. So let's get back down. I might have missed him at the tower itself, that he was just standing there in hopes of finding my corpse down below. I'm gonna shove my shield in his face. So let's go back down. Let's take the quicker route. That was almost too quick of a route. Hello, Patches, where are you? Doesn't look like he's here. Didn't really miss him. But I don't see him around here either. So maybe he entered Firelink Shrine proper. Could be. Maybe around here, where the doggy is. Oh. Why is there an item here? Hawkwood's shield. Wait a second, isn't that the Artorias greatsword? That's weird. What was this Hawkmoon shield? That wasn't here, right? Here. Hawkwood's shield. Wait, Hawkwood, wasn't that shield that belonged to Hawkwood, a deserter from the Undead Legion? Oh, that was the Crestfallen Warrior. The unique swordsmanship of the Watchers does not normally allow for the use of shields. The unique swordsmanship of the Watchers... Okay. Would not allow such a shield, and Hawkwood's very possession of it was telltale of his defeat. So he died, I suppose, so that's why we couldn't find him anymore. Because the poor man is dead. They do seem to be dying an awful lot lately, because I'm gonna presume Greyroth is dead as well. Patches, where is Patches? Upstairs? No. Oh yeah, there he is. There he is.
Ah, look, you're alive. Now, hold your horses. Let's have a nice talk about this. I'll come clean. I did you wrong. I didn't mean it, though. Not one bit. You get these urges running the business and all, and I
there you go, sword in your stomach.
You know what I mean. but I can see you'll forgive me. You're alive, after all. And that's what counts, right?
Yeah, okay, I have always forgiven him, so, because the benefits are plenty.
Oh, fantastic. A wily second chance. I knew you'd understand, I just knew it. The heart of a lion, a model for the rest of us. A true friend, forever.
Okay, so, we can... Ooh, he's called Unbreakable Patches in this game. Funny. So let's see what he sells. Because he sells the Katarina armor, so from Siegwart. Then we have black leather armor, and that appears to be it. Distinctively shaped helm worn by the knights of Katarina, often ridiculed for its onion-like shape, infuriating the country's proud knights. But the massively forged curved design makes it very effective for deflecting blows. And then the shields. Center of the shield features a large sharpened spike which is used to skewer opponents. And then everything else, shuttle. Shuttle is interesting. But that appears to be it. You can buy poison arrows from him. But that's it.
Can't find anything you like. Well, you could try look.
Maybe we can talk to him again.
We're just a couple of outcasts. Let's make the best of it.
Okay then,
can't
find patches.
Anything you like. Well,
so I'm gonna warp back to where we left off. And then I'm gonna take a little break probably. Oh, don't fall off. There we go. Rests. And let's... I don't think... No undead bone shard, so let's travel to the Dragonslayer Armour bonfire. So not all the butterflies are dead, clearly, because there's still a few flying around. Praise the sun all the more time for joy. I don't know. Doesn't look like joy to me. I do want to check it out really quickly. Liar ahead. Okay then. Because this is cool. Is this actually... Wait a second. Is this the bridge that we could see... Oh no, that's the bridge that we could see. From down at the wall over there. Interesting. I wonder if I can actually kill one of these. But hey, let's go quickly check out the other side and I'll head up the stairs and probably end it there. It's cool that the blue also has the amber effect. Dead end ahead. Maybe there's something here. Nope. Okay, so let's go up. And check this place out. Could this be a message? Yes. Wait, what? Why is there another bonfire here? That is by far the most useless bonfire ever to have bonfired. What the fuck? Okay, what's this? Is this someone I'm supposed to know? Grand Archives Key and Gotthard Twin Swords. Aye, huh. It's a play dead. Doesn't look like he's playing dead. Let's quickly check out those swords. If I would find them. Oh, there we go. Swords paired. The hunters known as the King's Black Hands wielded paired weapons. These belonged to Gotthard, who fled the castle. Gotthard rose quickly through the knighthood, no surprise to those who have witnessed his swordsmanship. So the same spinning attacks. It has a bit of scaling, not amazingly, but it actually looks pretty cool. And it's a trusting weapon, so Godar. That's not creepy at all. Okay. Oh. Okay, the Grand Archives. Great. So now we have a few options, because we could go down to the consumed garden as well. Oh, so maybe this comes up from the consumed garden, and that, well, that would explain why there's a bonfire over here. So might as well go to the consumed garden next, but that will be for next episode, so I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, another boss fight episode, don't forget to like this video right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you might give me. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!